Okay, so,
Alright.
I'm just gonna keep that one in, but I'm here with another video on Twilight Princess today, and I'm just gonna do some more glitches here, because my last video on Twilight Princess HD got a lot of views due to the, the long jump attack glitch, and so I'm just gonna do a compilation, I guess, of just some various glitches I found. A very minor one that I found here was on this screen right here, you can press the plus sign down there, and it'll take you into this screen where it'll show you a collection of amiibos, and when you exit out, the whatever you have on your screen on the right there is gone. And it's just a minor graphic glitch. You can just do that and see the few shadows are back, but and it doesn't affect the game at all. It's just a tiny graphic glitch that probably got overlooked. So you can see I have the mirror shards here, and then I just do that and they're gone, and up they're back. And you can even start the file. I have nothing there. And you can start the file like this too, and it won't change anything, because we can look. Oh wait, wrong button. Let me look here, and I still have them. So where am I at? First, I want to go over here and show off something. Now, I want to get the spinner here. Wait, is that? Okay, so I want to get to the. You want to get to the top of this tree up here, and now Horden Village. And you're gonna need the spinner for this glitch. And these are all really minor glitches. That's why they're just in a compilation instead of a one long video for each one like I did with the long jump attack. So we wanna get up here. And there we go. And all you have to do is just go off the edge, or get on the spinner, go off the edge, and just guide yourself up here, and it didn't work for some reason, because I bumped into that tree. I'm going to see if I can just use this. Alright. Really glad they sped up the climbing speed in this version. So just gonna do that again. Try not to bump into that, and then we can go up here, and we phase through here, and you just fall. That's one way you can die here, and village. Another way is to get up over here and just, I guess, swim, or you want to get up right here and then take your claw shot out and take your claw shot out and press ZL along with the claw shot button, and you can kind of phase through the ground and some in places. So like right here, we're swimming in a place we normally shouldn't be, so we just go right over here. I can just clip through that wall and you'll fall. And the next thing here in Orden is this right over here. I want iron boots for this. Now, first thing I want to show off before I do this is over here, there is a gate, and as far as I know, this is just here, and you just can't get over it. And it wasn't there in the original, and I think it's just there for, and just to be there, really, because it doesn't do anything. There's nothing on the other side. But, and as far as I know, there's no way to actually get over it, without using any glitches, like this one I'm about to do. So we want to take out the bomb here, place it, and then get up. No. No. Oh. So, go stand over right here by this, this overgrowth, I guess. Place the bomb behind you and just grab on. And the bomb oh. Maybe. Hang on. I hope I'm doing this right. Okay. Maybe. I don't think this has anything to do with it, but I'm just gonna try it anyway. And I'm out of bombs. There we go. So now we're in the water. We're inside this little thing here. So we'll go ahead and put this on. And then use your iron boots and get under here a little bit. And with the Zora armor, you can just kind of float wherever. And you can only swim along where there's water in the village. So if you go out, like, you can see where the water ends in the map. And if you go out, you can only be under the water. You can't go outside of it. Otherwise, you'll just fall to your death. So I guess that's another way you could die. So here, I can get behind this gate. There's nothing here, I don't think. That's not what I want to do. Transform. I don't think there's... no, nothing. And there's these rocks. Just like any other rocks in the game. I do have blue rupees, though. I don't know if those are always there. And there's this thing, and that's it, really. I guess you could go fishing. I don't know if there's any special fish here. And you could just phase right through. Can't normally do that, though. It's one-way collision, but, so, next thing I want to do is head over to Kakariko Village. So, I'll just do that. So... wanna over here? No, not Death Mountain. Okay, so where you actually want to go is right here, to Kakariko. But I always end up going to Death Mountain by accident because it's at the top, and I forget it's a place. All right, so here. I could just hell up here, actually. Get some of these fairies. Yeah, that's another thing in this game. I don't know if it's in the original, but I noticed it here. Whenever you... I don't know what it is, but with the healing sound, it can just kind of glitch like that, and it'll play over and over in a short time period, and just kind of make that noise like it did just now. This one, I want to get in this water, and this piece of the ground right here is going to help us out. Actually, hang on. Where is Michael? But I'll save that for later. But you still want to do this. You can just kind of swim through this ground here. Swim all the way over. Can't swim through her though. She's got collision all around, so you can just kind of go right through, and you can swim all the way to the edge. I haven't discovered anything else you can really do, so we'll go transform. Wait, no, we won't. I want to go to this house over here on the left side, or I guess right if you're in playing Heroes mode, or not Heroes mode, normal mode. I'm on Heroes mode. Right here. Want to transform into a wolf, and as Wolf Link, you want to just jump out. And then just want to transform back to regular Link and head back over into that water over there. So, right over here, we want to head back. We're gonna use that piece of the wall right there that I said we'd use before. And so we just wanna take a claw shot, CL, and go back into this mode again, and right here, I believe. There's a part somewhere right here. I know it's not this. It's right here. Gonna have to change the angle if it doesn't work. Still haven't gotten it down quite yet. There we go. So we just can clip right through that wall. And then, since I set my spawn point as Link in a place where I should only spawn as Wolf Link, that weird animation happens. But yeah, you can use that to lose health here, and you can just trigger that little weird cutscene or animation, whatever, of Link falling. Next thing I want to show off. Wanna warp to over here in Castle Town, or well, next to Castle, actually, yeah, next near Castle Town. Still haven't completed the Cave of Shadows in this game. It's really hard, but oh yeah, I'm also gonna be doing I should stop doing that, but I'm also gonna be using the Ganondorf amiibo and Hero mode to be playing a hardcore 4x damage mode on the other channel, probably sometime this summer, but yeah, because that's when I'll be getting a new setup and everything. So because I did start a playthrough on there of Twilight Princess on my GameCube version, and I know I didn't finish it, but we're gonna come back with Twilight Princess HD 4x damage. So right here, it's not really something useful, but right, you can kind of use a great jump attack to just get on the edge here. I don't know if you can actually get over, but just get on there. And I've tried multiple ways of getting over, but I don't think you can. And so I also got an action replay for my GameCube, so I might be doing some videos on Just some various cheat codes of different games. I don't know, whatever I decide on. But I did find a lot of codes on Twilight Princess, and I've been messing around with those. Well, and Ocarina of Time. But the Collector's Edition, since Ocarina of Time has a GameCube version. So now, here. What do I want to do? I want to go over here. So, no, wait. Hang on, maybe Epona's still here. And she's not. But I want to go to South Hyrule Field. And over here on the... Wait, where's my map? There it is. It's on the right side here. Or I guess left on the... on normal mode. There's this pit. And I want to call Epona here. So here's the horse call. Take her over to the edge, right? Oh, and just as far as you can, just turn. Hang on, like this. Have her kind of angled like that and lined up almost parallel to the to this giant pit here. And then you just want to talk to her. There's a way you can do this where she'll push you off the ledge. Okay, hang on. Try and get this right. Here we go. It's probably a better place. Yeah, this is much better. Okay, maybe not. Okay, it might be the right side of her. A circle all the way around. So I wanna kind of line her up. She keeps turning around. It's not like Ocarina of Time where you can just press back to make her back up. Even though that was really annoying at times. Here we go. Let's just have her like this. See if this works. Transform. Got it. Try again. That's okay. Just want to stand right beside her, talk, and she almost pushed me off. Which I wanted to get her to push me off while she's talking. Alright, let's try this again. And I'm probably gonna... Okay. Actually, I'm gonna try it over here on this side. Probably works better. I don't know. Some side it worked really good, really well. I'm gonna just get as close to the edge as possible. Just see if this will work. So this is probably the best I can get it gotten it to work on my I think this will, weird stuff is happening. That's not what I wanted, but we'll stick with it because this is actually the place I want to go. So, here, oh no, I need a wolf form. Okay. Actually, I want that too. Alright, so, not you. So, we just want to call this bird here. And you just wanna fall down. And so that way you set your spawn point here as Wolf Link. And the bird's asking you to play the minigame again, which you can usually only do as Wolf Link normally. Some of you might know this, the infinite bombs and arrows glitch is what we're trying to do right now. And this is the part where I get stuck. Now. So I want to line myself up with the waterfall. And just want to go through this piece of land right here. And I should go through. Unfortunately, it's not working for some reason. So that means that there's just simply no way through here, unless I'm doing it in the wrong spot. I've already tried messing around with other pieces of land to see if I could phase through there and die as Because if I die as Human Link here, then I'll spawn in Wolf Link's spot, and I'll be able to play the minigame and do some other things. Then you'll have infinite bombs and arrows. But, can't get through this wall, so... I don't think it works. So... I can't get this glitch to work. If anybody else knows how to get it to work, please let me know. And the next... So... I've got one more I want to show. Okay, so here, back on the title screen, I have this file set up called EMS. Stands for Early Master Sword. That's because this is the file that I use for the Early Master Sword glitch, and I have to get to the spot first. Okay, so on the other side over here, I want to get to... Have my map up. Yes, this little part of the map. You can see the mini map in the bottom left corner of the screen. I'm the yellow arrow, and you can see where I am on the map. And this is where you want to get. And you could can only be in the twilight. And so it's only at this one point of the game. It's about an hour in, and that's the reason why I made it its own file, so I could keep trying again. You want to get this shadow beast. Over here, up against this wall. It's kind of difficult. It's probably the most difficult glitch I've done, and I've never actually done it, so I don't know 100%. I think it works on this version. I'm 99% sure of that. And that's not what you want to do. Get him up against the wall, and then that's not what you want to do either. So... You need this one alive. He needs to be up against the wall on this lowest point. And as he's raising his hand up, like that, at his arm's highest point, you wanna... Well, you're gonna wanna be charging this attack, and at his arm's highest point, release it. And then if you do it right, you'll jump, and you'll land on the top of this ledge, and through a series of careful walking and jumping, you can get... into the Sacred Grove, and then to the Master Sword. And I haven't actually done it on this version. And I don't even know if it still works on this one. I think it should, because I've attempted this a lot on this version. I've never even done it on the original. But from the way it looks, it should work. But that I also said the same thing about bombs and arrows, and that ended up not working. But this is a way harder glitch, so... I'm not sure if it's just me or whatever. It's really hard. So, that's all for now. So, thank you for watching, and that's it really. So, okay, thanks.